I knew I could count on you.
Before we start today's video, check out our affiliate links in the description down below. These can make some great gifts with the holiday season just around the corner, or even a gift for yourself. It supports the channel at no extra cost of you. Thanks so much. May the force be with you, and enjoy the video.
Hello there.
This is where the fun begins.
What's up, guys? Unofficial Star Wars here. Hope you're all doing well, and most recently, Iman Esfandi, the actor behind Ezra Bridger in live action and the Ahsoka Disney Plus series, had recently come out to give us a few new reveals, tidbits, teases, and an overall kind of just synopsis on reflecting back on making this character come to life for Ahsoka, even saying of how he had this spiritual connection to the character when taking on the role. So we're gonna go ahead, we're gonna hop right on into it, break it all down for you guys, everything that we know and everything that we would be anticipating right now. Before we do though, however, grab that subscribe button if you haven't already, as we're discussing and covering all types of Star Wars related news, leaks, rumors, theories, and breakdowns here on the channel. So if you guys are into any of that, go ahead and grab that subscribe button today. Okay, so in this video, we are going to be taking a quick read from one of my favorites out there, StarWarsNewsNet.com, as an overall garnering source. I'll have their article linked in the description down below for you guys to check out there as well. In the latest podcast episode of the Sackhoff Show, Katie Sackhoff, the actress behind Bo-Katan Kryze within live action and animation, recently taken some time to sat down and interview Iman Esfandi, the actor behind Ezra Bridger in live action and in Ahsoka, to talk about his career and how he came to the role of Ezra Bridger in Ahsoka for one. Esfandi had began with detailing his audition process and how he felt like he was conversing with the spirit of the character when auditioning, which is far-fetched and of course is a little bit crazy, but he is that of a diehard Star Wars fan and himself, like many of us would be as well. At the first, Esfandi was unfamiliar with the character, but after stumbling upon the discussions of the character online, he saw how the character had resembled himself. He talks about that more in quote, "I didn't know Clone Wars or Rebels, and I had only ever really seen Revenge of the Sith, the Star Wars film, and I was online, and something came up about someone playing Space Aladdin, and I saw that, and I was like, what? I should play Space Aladdin. I didn't know what that meant or anything, but just off of that, and I look it up, and it's Ezra. So here we are talking about who should play Ezra, and I'm like, what is this Ezra? And then there's a picture of him by Pandora Young Art, and it's this older version of the maid of what Ezra would look like when his character does come back from being cast away on this other galaxy, Peridia. And it looked like me, kind of." Ending that quote right there. I find it ridiculously funny of how he just goes from not knowing anything about the character, or really even at that, about the franchise, aside from, well, of course, being in love with the prequels and mentioning Revenge of the Sith, of course, and then going onto those online discussions and stumbling upon the different lore and the facts from there, from the fan base, let alone. For reference, the artwork by Pandora Young, which Esfandi says had changed his life, Esfandi later says that he felt like he had a conversation with the spirit of Ezra as a character when he had dived further into the character's lore, saying more of that there in quote, "So I go and I look it up and I watched a little bit of Rebels, the animated show, and then I get this interesting intuitive feeling I have this dialogue, it feels like, with a Force Ghost version of Ezra in my living room, and I'm kind of like, what's going on?" Ezra's like, "What's up, man? I'd love to come through to you and be in your world." And I'm like, alright, this is so weird, but I'm down. You're Jedi, and I'm down, so I say yes to Ezra. Ending the quote right there. Hey, I need whatever edibles he had, honestly. That's pretty funny, that in itself. And I'm not trying to like completely joke or take away by it, but the whole situation and the whole explanation that he serves behind this like a legit conversation with the character, like in his living room, is kind of funny. Like, I don't have conversations with Yoda in my living room, or do I? But you guys get the point. All in the same time, it can be a bit comical, but at the same time, it's a sense of realness to it, I think, all at the same time. And throughout the audition process, he again references this spiritual connection that he had felt that he had to the character. Esfandi states further that this same feeling came to him again when auditioning for the casting directors, saying and explaining more of that there in quote, "The intuition tells me to send these photos of me and Ezra side by side, and I send it to my agents and my managers, and I told them, like, hey, when this is casting, I'm gonna play this character, so use these photos." And they're like, kind of like, what are you talking about? Are you talking about Star Wars and this animation? Are you going to be on live action or what is it? I don't really explain anything except my manager calls me up and I go, this is one of those spiritual things and we'll just have to see how it plays out. And he's like, all right, man, I trust you. And also, I hope it happens because he grew up on Star Wars. 6 months later, I get the ominous audition while I'm doing a different film. Within a couple of days, I was offered the role. I definitely felt connected to Ezra when that audition came back again, and I was like, oh, Ezra, what's up? You're back. Ending the quote right there. I think it's, if you guys know anything of the actor himself, Iman Esfandi is a very comedical character all in the same time, referencing, like, similar to how Temuera Morrison will reference his characters, Boba Fett, like, in the third person, like, or how Elmo, you know, kind of referenced himself in the third person. It's very similar to that, and explaining that in a bit of a comedical way, but all at the same time, I do believe him, and I get that, like, the realness behind it. As I had mentioned, it's a comedical part of it, but then there's also just this, like, very real side to it all at the same time. Like, I feel you and feel like how you're feeling essentially. It is more than likely at that, probably confirmed, that we'll likely see the return of Ezra Bridger with Iman Esfandi for season 2 of Ahsoka, as he does a fantastic job at taking on the character and bringing the character to life for live action, and as well 10 years after the events of the Ahsoka, or after Star Wars Rebels animated show, and then into the Ahsoka show here as well. So having him back for the second season of Ahsoka, not just that, but having him play an even larger role, not just inside of Ahsoka season 2, but inside and out of that with the greater, grander Mandoverse. I hope to maybe have him pop up somewhere in the Mandalorian and Grogu movie. We have another video discussing and talking about that, so go check that video out if you haven't already. So having him play much more of a larger role in Ahsoka season 2 is just a definite, because it took the character some time to find this other galaxy, find the characters of Thrawn and Ezra that were on this planet of Peridia in another galaxy for Ahsoka season 1. So now that he's back in the main Star Wars galaxy, I think that we'll honestly, if for anything, maybe see a little bit more of Ezra than Ahsoka and Sabine themselves, as they'll be off on Peridia doing whatever kind of goes on with that. That may be some time, however, as Natasha Labordizzo, who plays Sabine Wren in the Ahsoka Disney Plus series, had recently taken to confirm and state that Ahsoka Season 2 will begin filming in summer of 2025 and probably won't be anticipated until 2026 for a Disney Plus release. Guys, this here all being said, let me know all of your thoughts and opinions in the comments down below. I would love to hear what you guys are all thinking. Thanks so much for watching today's video. Of course, this has been Unofficial Star Wars. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Have a great one. May the Force be with you as always. Peace out.